There's no question that the bristly mammoth is a special case. It's a specimen that is dramatic in the completeness, certainly, of the head and the tusks. Its recovery was dramatic, the scene of it being lifted from the ground. Many people from this region have watched it on the news, they've seen reports of it, they've heard about it. And so there's a lot of sense of ownership and participation in the work on this specimen. As a result, we have made our best effort to decrease the usual span of time between discovery and opening of a display. We're opening our exhibit 1 year after the original one-day excavation. Each of the two tusks had some fracturing, so these parts had to be very carefully examined, and a long process of gluing pieces back together began. What will appear in the exhibit is a cast of one of the tusks. What people will see of the skull is the whole specimen as we have it. The teeth actually in the skull will be casts of the real teeth so that we can continue to do research on the real ones. There will also be some parts of the skull that were broken loose in ancient times that are part of our evidence of human association at this site. We have modeled those in 3D and then printed them with a 3D printer. And it will be the 3D printed pieces that will be put back in place on the skull so that you'll be able to look at the whole thing and say, yes, that's where humans broke pieces to take loose great chunks of meat. When it comes to the question of when an animal like this lived, we have a very good method. The method, most people know it, is radiocarbon dating. We did take a sample from this animal, and we sent that off to a lab for analysis. We got a number back. It was a very, very interesting number. I had expected that this one was going to be older than most. The date we got was fully as old, if not older, than what we expected. We're being cautious about announcing the date that we received from the lab, because in science we always want not just one line of evidence, we'd like to see multiple analyses, and we'd like to see the congruence or the agreement of those multiple analyses. We have now arranged with the Bristle family to go back and reopen the site. We will obtain a series of sediment samples from the layers of sediment that we can use for checking the date. So if everything comes back and the whole argument hangs together, then we'll feel comfortable presenting that body of evidence to the scientific community and, of course, to the public at large.